We join now by Suresh Khanna, who's Senior Territory Partner for Africa at PwC, and he sits on the King Committee of Corporate Governance.
Good governance is about embracing all your stakeholders, whether the employees, whether the customers, everybody in the supply chain. I think it's important to embrace them all, and that's a fundamental principle. Now, King 3 has been around for a while, perceived to be very applicable to the large listed companies. You've heard about the announcement of King 4 now. And the purpose of King 4 is to simplify and make it more applicable, more broad-ranging, to simplify the principles from the real practice things that people have to do. So I think it's going to get the balance a lot more better. The spotlight's on everybody. So, you know, you just have to have good governance to be a successful business.
To get the growth that we need in South Africa of up to 7% to start really bringing down unemployment of 25, persistent unemployment at 25. It needs to come from the small business sector. Mm-hmm. But is enough being done to develop these small businesses? Is it a problem of not enough entrepreneurs, or is it a financing, funding problem?
Financing is a big element of it. Entrepreneurial skills is a big element of it. But, you know, in South Africa, I think you've seen lots of programs developing, lots of institutions being formed to assist in this space to develop entrepreneurs. And so I think it's hopeful that we do get better in that space. You know, the reality is, you know, as an organization like PwC, we do a lot of our work in a small market area. We perceived as being just serving the very large clients, but, you know, about 40% of our turnover is in that market.
You're obviously in charge of the Africa, strategy for PwC.
When you look at just a trend like urbanization, and you're seeing just new cities developing, and as we look at the projections over the next 25 years, you know, currently there's about 52 cities across Africa that have a population of a million and more. But in the next 25 years, we expect another 440 new cities to come across in Africa. And those 440 cities will need everything that you need, to run, to have a city. Right from soft infrastructure to hard infrastructure, to consumerism, everything that we need. And you could just imagine the consumer boom that arises out of that. So it's a huge opportunity. And I think we're seeing it in all across Africa. I think there are some areas of higher growth. I mean, Nigeria is a very, very good market. Ghana is a very, very good market. And some of our East African economies are also doing very, very well. So I think it's very promising. And we're seeing a lot of that also coming through from small business.
Are we heading into this kind of growth phase, or are we being held back by the banks that are a little bit unwilling to lend?
Yeah, look, I think we go through these phases, and you know, as we know, African Bank had a bad experience recently, and that sends shivers down everyone's spine in terms of investment, and we can't be encouraging those kind of things. So banks have to be conservative by nature in terms of what they do, because they deal with public funds and they deal with depositors. Holders funds, and if that goes sour, it affects the confidence in any economy. So I think banks will look for what they need, you know, in terms of to make sound investments. But I think, you know, it still goes on. I think it's more about how organizations manage the business, how they perceive the risks, how they manage those risks, how they identify where the challenges are, and put proper sound processes around them. So organizations have to, and I think that's where the principles of good governance comes in. You have to have, develop and build organizations that are resilient to these kind of issues, so that, you know, you don't have a single event that could wipe out an organization.